Attention all business owners and creative minds. Do you need a unique and personalized touch for your products? Look no further than Romika Laser Engraving and Custom Designs. I'm Ron Phillips, co-owner of Romika Designs. We offer custom laser engraving services for a variety of products, including promotional items and corporate or personal gifts. With state-of-the-art equipment and a team of skilled designers, we can engrave intricate designs on virtually any material. Whether it's a special message, a company logo, or a custom design, Romika Laser Engraving will help you make your mark. And the best part? Our prices are affordable and our turnaround time is quick.
I couldn't be happier with the work Romika Laser Engraving did for me. The engraving on my product was precise and exactly what I wanted.
So don't wait any longer to add a personal touch to your products. Call Romika Laser Engraving and Custom Designs today at 817-400-4040 or visit our website at romikadesigns.com. We look forward to helping you make your mark.
Hey, travelers, do you want to save money on your next flight? Then pick up the phone and call. That's right, call, because the best prices are not online. They're with SmartFares. See, SmartFares has special deals with the airlines. When they have unsold seats, they use SmartFares to fill them. So you get airline tickets at ridiculously low prices. Our prices are too low to publish online. With the extra money you'll save, you can book another trip or treat yourself to dinner or shopping. So stop searching all of those travel sites to find the lowest price on your next flight. Let one of our SmartFares expert travel agents find ridiculously low prices for you. Call SmartFares today and get the best price on your next flight. Guaranteed. Also, save up to 50% off business and first class tickets.
855-325-1820. 855-325-1820. That's 855-325-1820.
Let's be honest. Wheelchairs are heavy, bulky, and ugly. Introducing the Feather Chair Wheelchair. Order yours today and get a free wheelchair case of $50 value. The world's lightest wheelchair is just $4.99 with easy payments as low as $16 a month. Sorry, no Medicare or insurance accepted. So call right now to order yours.
800-823-5826. That's 800-823-5826.
Have you ever met a single person in your life that enjoys paying taxes? No, no one does. If you can't sleep at night because you have a huge problem with the IRS, I've got some free advice for you. This service is strictly limited to individuals that owe the IRS $10,000 or more in back taxes. And if you qualify, we can guarantee that you won't be writing a big fat check to the IRS or our services cost you nothing. The first 100 people that call today will get a free tax consultation worth $500. Stop worrying about your IRS problem. We can help you, we promise. Call the tax doctor right now. I mean right now to learn more.
800-240-4587. 800-240-4587. 800-240-4587. That's 800-240-4587.
Fast Track Student Loans can get your student loans out of default, stop any wage garnishments, stop collection calls, and stop seizure of your tax refund. Give yourself a break. Stop the stress and get your student loan payments down to as little as $25 a month based on what you can afford to pay. 800-709-4395. 800-709-4395. 800-709-4395. 800-709-4395.
It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
Hello, hello, Johnson County. This is Destiny with Banded Together Through Music, and we are so excited to be here today. It is a Monday. Imagine that, Mondayest of Mondays. But we have an amazing special guest here with us today, Roger. Can you say hello, Roger?
Hello, Destiny.
How are you?
I'm great. Thank you very much for having me.
Absolutely. We are so stoked. You're one of our favorite people. Don't tell anybody. Gotta keep it a secret.
I think people already know.
I think the whole world knows now. So, Roger, you are a singer, songwriter, rock star.
I was a wannabe rock star.
A wannabe.
Now I want to be anonymous with a big hit.
A father, a yes. husband, you kind of do it all. Yep. Those are the most important roles here in life sometimes. It's not just about being a rock star.
Yeah, there's a lot more to life. It takes life to learn that, unfortunately.
Yeah. We still may ask for an autograph afterwards, just in case.
As long as it's not on a check. Okay.
That might be a good autograph there. Blank check. Sir, we need your autograph after every show.
Pay the bills that way.
It would. So you came all the way from?
From South Jersey.
All the way from, just for the show.
I grew up in a little town called Maple Shade, New Jersey. I'm one of nine kids. And that probably defines who I am. I grew up with a very talented friend who lived down the street. My mother called him the kid down the street. He's Steve Oakley, a fantastic singer-songwriter. And we made a band when we were little, and we did it for 20-something years and made four or five records, and it was great.
Yeah.
We didn't make it big. I think the Muppets got the rich and famous contract we were looking for. I normally blame Matchbox 20, but we'll go with the Muppets this time. But they, we made great music. And then I met Kim mm-hmm. and moved to Texas.
And you haven't been, contemplating leaving since, right?
I love Texas. It's not that I don't love South Jersey. I love Philadelphia, but Texas just fits.
Have you been back since?
Yeah.
Do you go and visit?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. We have family still there.
Oh, okay.
All 1,100 of them. So.
Do they ever come to Texas to visit you too?
Yeah. When we got the house, well, you probably know all this kind of stuff, right? When we got the house, I said, don't get any extra rooms because no one's going to visit. I was wrong. People have visited and we've had a great time. We have the full tour we give them. Yeah, we go to Stockyards as many times as possible. Take them to Stand on the X. We take them to get barbecue. All the normal Texas things you do. We mm-hmm. give them a good tour. So, but it's fun.
I was going to say, talk to anybody outside of the state and they'll tell you we're still riding, horses out in the street and roping up the ladies. And
yeah, there was a bit of that when we were moving here. There were two things that were in question. Would we ride a horse to work? A couple of people asked if we needed a passport, but I think they were just kidding to get in here. But the other thing was that how could an Eagles fan move to Dallas Cowboys fans territory?
Oh,
like what would that be like? Well, fortunately, we don't watch a lot of football anymore. So
you don't have time.
So it's not really a factor. Right? So no, we're busy. We're just really busy.
Yeah. Well, we already had a fan on here that said, hi, Roger. Texas is lucky to have you.
Aww.
And that's from Kiki. So I love it.
Kiki is a top poster, top commenter on my music page.
Good. I'm glad to hear that.
I feel very lucky.
We need that. I think on the show, I think that's one thing that everybody has kind of come into agreeance. Every musician is, and every human really, I think, who walks in to the station says they need support. We need that.
Yeah, we had something really good in Philadelphia. And I think it kind of, I don't say fell apart, it just dissolved in my rear mirror in like 2014. I'm sure it went on bits and pieces after that. And I'm sure it's perspective based on leaving and then the group who I was involved with. But the group I was involved with, they were very good at supporting each other. We would have shows and our friends would be on all the shows. So we'd rent a place for the night and then run five bands. And all the
awesome.
Bands supported. I swear all we did was trade cover charges to each other half the time. We could see their shows. They could see our shows. That allowed everyone to make records, everyone to improve. And we played in each other's bands. And it was a lot of fun. Kind of probably looked a little inbred at times. But we were able to pretty much control the market and take an elevator original music up to really prominence, to where we got the big shows, where the cover bands and tribute bands of the day didn't get the big shows. The original acts got the big shows because we all support each other like crazy. But we had one other thing, and this is why this is so important. What you do is so important. We had incredible radio support. Incredible. Out of Wilmington, out of Philadelphia. It just was awesome radio support. They had an annual event giving out awards to people and everything. It was crazy.
Yes.
So that's what we need here. We need the original acts to kind of combine and just kind of build from there, build a nucleus and support each other. I think that's what Bandit's all about.
It is. It is. I think that one thing that has been a very big passion of ours, which I absolutely love, even about JoCo Radio as a whole, is it's about supporting the original arts. It's about supporting the people that need it. And it's about incorporating small local businesses to be a part of the community. And it's easy to have those hopes and dreams like being a Walmart or a Target. But the truth is, the community support, the people, the honesty, the love, it comes from people doing all that we all do, and that we're all busting our butt to do something different.
That's true. And I left that part out, which I'm glad you said that, is we had a couple of places in the community that ran festivals. They'd run events. Like, one was called Hollystock in Mount Holly. The driving force was a little bar slash venue or restaurant slash venue downtown in this little mini city. Mm-hmm. And they ran a full festival every year, and it was great. I flew back one year to do it.
No.
I mean, it was really something.
Well, I know here in Burleson area, they have, I want to say it's the beer one that's coming up that they're doing. And I know that Brooke, who's a local, is really trying to bring in local bands, local people. I do think that we have to kind of stay banded together to really push the original music. That's one thing that we love to do, is having artists on that have originals. That's not to say there's not great art with tributes and everything, but when you can build something from the ground up, like for me, that's the true art of what we're doing. And you don't always have to, I don't want to say agree with it. Sometimes you don't always have to love it for the exact genre or the exact reason that they created it, but you can find love and a little bit of soul to fit where you need it to be, whether it's the lyrics.
I've always been an original musician. So, when you say that and think, well, we copy our Clapton, we copy Stevie Ray Vaughan if we can, right? Mm-hmm. And, but you think about this. So in a cover band, you go out at night, and invariable two things will happen. One is somebody will play Take It Easy. And somebody will play the Darius Rucker copy of Bob Dylan song.
Mm-hmm.
So the bands will play that every night. It's like guaranteed. And you think about it, Take It Easy was a half-done song by Jackson Browne.
Yeah.
That was taken over by Glenn Frey, and now every band on the planet plays it. And the same with the Bob Dylan song was recorded on a tape deck. And it went, mim, 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 and somebody finished it and made a song out. See, you have to have those. You have to have those songs that are just kind of ideas, and have people take them over and make them great.
Mm-hmm. Well, and someone jumped on here and said, out here, tribute bands are the ones that are getting the big shows.
Yeah, that's a trend in the industry. That's a trend, and I'm not a fan.
I don't blame you.
And I'm not a fan for different reasons. One, I think it's indicative of booking laziness. I think, we've all had a full schedule.
Of course.
And path of least resistance is to say, all right, we'll have the Eagles tribute band this night. We'll have the Guns N' Roses tribute band, like, and Bernie. And it makes it easy to book shows. Mm-hmm. It might take an hour to do your job instead of, say, 8 or 10 hours. And you don't have to really listen to anyone. You know what you're going to get.
Mm-hmm.
We're within reason. But then the other thing from me point of view, because remember, I wasn't the singer in my band. I was for 25 years, I was the other singer, the other writer. What if that singer had decided to go to a tribute band where the money is or where he wants to play? So if that's the case, then they're taking away all the good talent.
That's true.
And that's one of my issues. So they're taking away, a lot of good singers, mm-hmm. a lot of good singers, a good amount of guitar players and like 3 drummers.
So, and it's almost like they're like killing
just hot drummers.
The creativity of appreciating, again, something that is handmade, something from scratch, I think we talked about it just a few shows ago on quilts. You have quilts that used to be made with love and passion and dedication, and it was something beautiful to get a handmade quilt. And then we're talking about Walmart and Target, and here we do. We bring in something that can bring you a million quilts, right?
Mm-hmm.
With no love, no passion, no creativity, no, like, you can take that quilt and throw it away because your great-great-grandpappy didn't have a hand in making it. But when you have these artists out there that are dedicating time, energy, love, and they're making something, that's what we should be supporting. We should be supporting these arts that are so much more than just the same song or the same look. That's one thing that shocked me being introduced to a tribute band, is there wasn't even originality in how they sang the songs or how they look. They want to look and act like Chris Stapleton.
But that's part of the show. So I don't know if you call it vaudeville or it's just part of it. It's part of the show. It's part of the act, no different than Beatlemania would be. Mm. So they're dressed as the act to deliver that. I want to do it. I see them. I mean, I appreciate them for what they are. I think ultimately,
you respect it in a way. You just,
some of the greatest musicians I know are in tribute bands, and I don't hate them for it, but I wish they did original music. You know, come sing in my band, right? That kind of thing. So I guess the thing for me is that they're doing what they love. And not everyone in the band writes a song.
That's true.
So think about that. So if you're not the songwriter, if the band doesn't allow everybody to write and do what they want, and you just say, here's my song, here's the chart, play it, then all but one person is in a cover band.
Yeah.
It's a weird spot.
Yeah.
So you have to, as a leader in a band, be very careful and say vulnerable and give your music out to the band and have them create. And I think that's much more attractive long-term at the end of the night, at the end of the week, of carrying a whole bunch of equipment to have done your own stuff and have done it your way and that sort of thing. I also think there's one very important thing. It's like a Rogers thing. Rogers rant.
Quote, Roger.
Rogers rant for that. I think original music wins. I think long-term, I look in the camera over here, I absolutely believe that original music will win long-term. It always has. It will just convert. Saw this. It's a different, it's in our age. I've seen it go back and forth a couple times, but I think long-term people will want to hear new music eventually. There's only so many times you can hear Take It Easy and you've had enough.
Well, with that, I'm going to just swing right in and say, let's hear an original song. What do you think about that?
I think it's a good idea. I'm a big fan of that.
I'm a big fan of original music too. I think that's one thing that when I first met you, I really enjoyed was knowing that your entire set is typically original music.
Full show.
It's badass.
So it's 2 hours. 2 hours of all original music. And it's over years, though. It took years to get to that point. I got to do this thing.
Hold on. Okay. No worries. I was going to say Rain jumped on here and said exactly. And I think Rain likes to kind of add in his own play with, he does his music as well. And I think that is a tough spot sometimes for original artists to know that the tribute bands are taking over the originals.
Just be better.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. So if the original bands band together, right? Mm-hmm. If they do that and they play better and they attract the best musicians and make sure people have a good time, I think ultimately they win.
Yeah.
Because there's nothing better, like you said it about a quilt, but there's nothing better than a song that means something or makes you feel.
Absolutely.
It's very important. And yet sometimes you can't do that. But keep in mind, people want to go out and just blow off some steam too. So everything has a time and place.
I like how with the original songs too, which I'm sure the one you're about to play us, there's a story that is personal that may not relate to everybody in the same way it does to you. However, it can hit all your fans in a different way that could grow them as well. It could relate to them, or it could just make them have a good time.
Yeah.
Or it could make them think.
Depending what kind of music you play.
Yes.
So I'm going to tell a little bit about the song. So
okay.
I'm going to play Before I Let Go, which is the title track from my last CD. And I played this at an open mic a couple of years ago out at T's in Louisville. And the person who was hosting the open mic is the only person who ever came up to me and told me he knew what the song was about. And
it gives you goosebumps.
I hugged them because I knew what that meant. And, you know, we all have this thing where your life kicks our butt. And sometimes it kicks too hard and you don't know where to turn. And you hold on tightly to things that don't matter until it's too late. So, and I had a pretty good idea he was at that point based on his music. And when I played and he said that, I was already leaning in a little. And yeah, this is from when this is a very personal song. I wrote this about me. Like, as a writer, we listen to other people. I was taught that, you know, you listen to what everyone else says and you personalize it. But this is one that was, this is about me and a lot of troubles I went through. And I think a lot of people have gone through this kind of thing. So if you're holding on to things, you can never grab anything good. So hands are always full. All right. So it's called Before I Let Go. Remember I said about it, I like to have my feet on the ground?
Sounds like a song title.
Yeah. No kidding. I do, I said as I took the oath, it's what somebody else wrote. In my heart, I should have known. Some mistakes I've made haven't lasted this long. Most of them haven't been so wrong. This one won't leave me alone. I pray in my mind to all that I know before I let go. Wish that I could say more. This is not what we hope for. I close my eyes so I can't see what's about to come of me. This will set me free. I pray in my mind to all that I know. Before I let go. Before I let go.
Feel like I have to clap. That's a beautiful song.
Thank you.
Everybody's on here saying they love the harmonica mix on that.
Oh wow. Give me a second here to undo.
No, I think that little portion of it just really, you can feel the love you have for that song. Like, you can feel the emotion when you really wrote that.
Well, thank you. Like, it's it means a lot to me. And the band closes with that, which, you know, you've seen us play. And we, on the CD, it's there's no drums or electric guitar.
It's just
acoustic. It's different than this. I rearranged this so I could do it in an acoustic show. Mm. But so one of the secrets to, I'm a lead guitar player at heart. Mm-hmm. And I've only recently started applying what I learned on lead guitar to vocals, which seems crazy. You know, you're so many years in. But one of the things is when I'm playing harmonica and I'm playing a part, I'm ba-na-na-na-na-na. All I'm saying to my head is help me, please. Mm. Going, help me, please. Help mm-hmm. me, please. Because at that point, you're just at the end. And that's all you want is just help. Mm-hmm. So that's the idea.
It's like goosebumps all throughout. You guys can't see it on air, but... now, if anybody wanted to find that song, where can they find it?
Well, it is on Spotify, Apple, iTunes, YouTube. We talked about this ahead of time. I'm sure I made a list.
Yeah.
But you can
pretty much every streaming platform.
Yeah. And if you could just search for Roger Delaney, and it's Roger with a D, Delaney with one E. So it's R-O-D-G-E-R and Delaney, D-E-L-A-N-Y. And it's the same on every platform. One of the nice things about having a weird spelling of a name is RogerDelaney.com was open, mm-hmm. Facebook/Roger Delaney, YouTube/Roger Delaney, Spotify, all those just end with Roger with a D and Delaney with one A.
So everybody knows. And I think we posted it here on this link, you guys, for those who are listening. If you guys want to share it, that would be super supportive and helpful. Either sharing the live streaming here. If you guys want to go and like anything of Roger's, you can share it, spread it, let other people know that you got to hear him and you love what you hear. And even if you weren't a giant fan of that song, you know, I'm not going to think that I know how many songs are out there, but I know there's a few more.
Yeah. So there's an entire library under Mother Redcap.
That was my
old band's name.
Okay.
So there are, I don't know, 4 records and a whole bunch of singles. Personally, in my solo career, there's one full acoustic record, which mm-hmm. is called Moment of Truth, which is, you've heard the song many times. It's one of my favorites. It's great for getting people to play because it's a little blues style thing. And then there's a number CD, or another CD, which is Before I Let Go. And then there are singles in between.
Yeah.
So, which you heard me play the All Right to Love Christmas again at the Texas Songwriting Championship.
I did. Yeah, that was a fun one. I think Bronson's favorite that he's always talking about, you know, this one, which, Why'd You Wake Me?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I say it's just, I think it's the family's favorite.
It's funny. When we were writing songs way back when, producers would tell us that you have to have a middle part, you have to have a chorus. And now if I sit in with these different country bands on guitar, there's one chord progression the whole time. Mm-hmm. You know, you think about like one of the Chris Stapleton songs has 2 chords. It's a massive hit. And
yeah.
For years we got lectured on, and it kind of got beaten into my head. So Why'd You Wake Me is an old recording that I put on Moment of Truth, or not Moment of Truth, on Before I Let Go, so that... But it's weird. I love it. I love the song. And again, that's personal. So, you know, Before I Let Go is a very personal record. It was mm-hmm. stuff I would never released in a band, like, because I was cool.
Because you were cool.
That's, I love it, though. It's this D that makes it magic. One note stays the same over all of them. Yeah, so people like that. Every now and then I get a text back from Jersey from this guy, David Melendez. It's funny when you move, who stays uh-huh. in touch with you. You can never predict it, by the way. You'll never know. And David stayed in touch, and every now and then he'll just text me with what he's listening to. And almost always it's that song.
Oh, I love it.
So
yeah. Well, I think when you have those moments where something just sticks with you, you just kind of remember the song with the musician too, or the songwriter, or even a really good cover sometimes. Like we've sure. heard it where people yeah. are like, oh, this person sings that song. And you're like, wait a second. No, they don't. That's a cover. They're like, no, it's not. So you just kind of know those things. But you guys are more than welcome to check out all of his stuff. When we come back on for our next section of it, we're going to have you play another song or two for us. But in the meantime, you guys can check out all the social media streamings on there. Do you do harmonica in a lot of your songs, or is that just kind of your raw feeling?
So it's weird. When I do acoustic, I tend to do more harmonica.
Okay. Yeah.
And then I only do it on Moment of Truth when it's okay. The band.
Yeah.
I like harmonica, but it's a logistics issue. I don't want to wear this while I'm playing electric guitar.
That's true.
You are normally sitting down in this situation. There's really no excuse. Everyone says they like the harmonica. I probably should use it more, but I really only use it on Moment of Truth.
The question is, did you see that more in Jersey or more here in Texas?
It's universal.
Is it?
And okay. I have this theory. I think that women like the harmonica more than men. And I don't know why, but there's no logic to it, but they're the ones who would tell me, which is kind of cool.
That they like it.
Yeah, they say, oh, I think the harmonica. Mm-hmm. Which sometimes when I was immature, I'd be like, well, you don't like this singing?
Well, quick break, y'all, and then we will be back on here with Banded Together Through Music.
Why have thousands of aspiring authors teamed up with Christian Faith Publishing to publish their book? Because Christian Faith Publishing is an author-friendly publisher who understands that your labor is more than just a book. We provide authors freedom and flexibility throughout the publishing process, professional book editing, award-winning design, and some of the highest royalty structures in the publishing industry. And as always, you will retain 100% of the rights to your book.
I was looking to find a company that I could trust, one that assisted in the editing process completely.
The most important qualities that I was looking for was a publisher who is honest and upfront, no hidden costs or fees, and owning the rights to my own work.
Christian Faith Publishing will publish, market, and sell your books in all major bookstores, online booksellers, as well as specialty Christian bookstores. Call for your free author submission kit.
800-978-4812. 800-978-4812. 800-978-4812. That's 800-978-4812.
Let's be honest. Wheelchairs are heavy, bulky, and ugly. Introducing the Feather Chair Wheelchair. Order yours today and get a free wheelchair case, a $50 value. The world's lightest wheelchair is just $4.99 with easy payments as low as $16 a month. Sorry, no Medicare or insurance accepted. So call right now to order yours.
800-823-5826. That's 800-823-5826.
Fast Track Student Loans can get your student loans out of default, stop any wage garnishments, stop collection calls, and stop seizure of your tax refund. Give yourself a break. Stop the stress and get your student loan payments down to as little as $25 a month based on what you can afford to pay. 800-709-4395. 800-709-4395. 800-709-4395. 800-709-4395.
It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
Joe Co. Community Radio is a member of EMG, a radio and podcast collective, proudly serving communities like Johnson and Tarrant County, Texas. We are live 365 on the TuneIn Radio Network, along with our on-station app as well. Check out our lineup and more at tuneinjoco.com. We thank our valued partners in helping us amplify the voices of our communities. Yes, you heard the commercials, but be sure to connect with Todd Hurd and Associates, Attorneys at Law, and use code JOCO2024 for 25% off your first order at thetiffy.com. Also join the Swipe Nation today and save on your credit card processing at SwipeNationUSA.com. Locally owned and operated, folks. Please reach out to Tiffany at joe.co at jococommunityradio.com for any advertising rates. Y'all, as low as $50 a month. That is completely affordable. And we would absolutely love to have any extra sponsors here supporting our show and what we do here in Johnson and Tarrant County alike. So please reach out to Tiffany for any of that information. Again, y'all, this is Destiny with Banded Together Through Music. And we have Roger here today. And we are absolutely so excited to have him on the show. So, Roger, you just did one of your originals for us. Remind me of the name.
It's called Before I Let Go.
Before I Let Go. Had personal meaning to you, but I know you have another song right up your sleeve that's newish.
Yeah, new. Brand new. This will be the first time I've ever performed it in public. Not in an open mic. I did it once in an open mic.
We'll pretend you didn't say that.
And it was disastrous because I did on piano and I didn't tape down the pedal, so the pedal kept moving.
Oh.
Yeah, it was a bad moment.
Like
I should know better. I
skirted it away from you.
Yeah, just skirted away. So I'm going to play. So I'm going to play a song called Angels Gathering.
Okay.
And Angels Gathering was written by Susie Brady. And I met Susie at an open mic.
Oh.
And Susie, she did something that I don't know how it worked, in that she showed me the lyrics that she had for a poem and just it was on her phone. She just was standing here and she just leaned over and said, "Hey, why don't you look at these?" No thought of it. And I looked at it and I did something I never do. And I turned around and said, "I can make that a song."
So is she a fan or an artist?
Just a friend.
She's just a friend.
Oh, so she's just this beautiful lady who sings at open mics. So I go to open mic at the Maverick over in Carrollton every Wednesday. And they allow you to do, you can sing to a track. So they have full karaoke capability as well as a full band. They have a full back line. I play guitar for many artists there.
Okay.
And my band plays there as well. So Susie sings there. So she'll sing some of the older songs. I always say Susie and this other guy, Earl, keep the old song, the good songs alive, the really very priceless songs. And so she showed it to me. And I immediately could see the melody, like immediately. And that never happens. And a lot of people through the years would send, especially when you're young, they'll send you lyrics and say, "Hey, can you write a song out of this?" And everyone thinks they can be your your other writer. And it's hard because you don't know if you're good enough to do that. I mean, I'm not professional. I mean, I'm just, you know, a guy with a guitar, right? So I thought that. I immediately heard the melody. I knew what the chorus was. I went home. I recorded it on an iPhone. And I sent it to her as a demo. And
so did she ask you to do that? She showed you the poem and she just...
And I'm like, I can do something with this. And it's really good. And it's been a great experience. So I recorded it as a demo on my home recording setup, piano, a little bit of guitar, a little bit of bass, a little bit of bad rhythm, you know, because I'm not really rhythmically, I'm rhythmically challenged. And then I sent that to her and she loved it. And so I charted it out. So it's fully charted, like regular real music, like it's legit, because I want her to be able to play it on piano and sing with it and whatnot, because she plays piano. And after a while sitting with it, we went back and forth and we just decided that the demo was too good not to share. It's not like a national release quality, right?
Yeah.
But it's really good. And it is a song from the heart. The lyrics carry the song. So it wouldn't matter how I record it because the lyrics are so good, right? So meaningful mm-hmm. words that mean things, you know. So Megan, my daughter, did the artwork for it. It's gorgeous. This beautiful angel wing. And she did Before I Let Go and several other album covers for me. And she's just so talented. And so when we got together with Susie, Susie and I got on a speakerphone. We decided what the artwork would be and what the release date would be and all that kind of stuff. And here's a lady who started singing maybe 5 or 10 years ago, has a copyrighted song. A song's published. And it's on iTunes, Spotify, all the normal places. It's been out for, I guess, 2 weeks now. It's got 500 and something plays on YouTube.
So
which
exciting.
Is pretty cool.
Yes. Well, and I love that you kind of incorporated even the artwork within the family and what you guys are doing. Like it means something. Again, it's that handmade, beautiful thing that matters.
Yeah, it's kind of neat. So I know we don't have so much time, so I'm going to just indulge me for 1 second. So it's kind
of course.
You're a mom. To have your children involved in what you're doing is priceless. Mm-hmm. And I know why it's priceless, because my mom and dad aren't around anymore. And if I had something I shared with them that was this big that I could remember them by, that would be huge for me.
Yeah.
And I think that's it's special. That said, she's really, really good. Like we'd have to do video here so you could all see, but I'll draw a stick figure. like little winged birds I drew for her. And she researched that the swallow has this before I let go. And she drew the actual type of bird that matters. And she was able to take my stick figures of before I let go and turn it into a beautiful front and back record, like an old school album cover. And then she did the same thing with Angels Gathering. The amount of time we've spent talking about it could be measured in less than 10 minutes.
Oh,
she's that good.
She just instantly knew it was what worked and what you needed and what worked with the song and the album and everything.
Yeah, it's special.
Oh, I love that.
All right, so I'm going to try to muddle through this. So we'll, So the reason I say muddle through, if anyone's listening, is I recorded on piano, wrote and recorded on piano. Sometimes it's tough to translate, but again, the words carry the song. So here we go. Angels Gathering. Angels gathering, they're lining outside his door. I ask myself, should I let them in? I find I have no choice. Do I dare let them take him now? Will it hurt if I look out? I hear them knocking as the trumpets play his song. Come home, my son, come home. 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 I know I have to let them in. I know he's ready to go. But my tears are flowing and I can't breathe with angels outside the door. I let them in. I could see him smile again. Come home, my son. Come home. Come home, my son. Come home. Come home, my son, come home. Come home, my son, come home. I'm glad I let the angels in. I can see him smile again. Come home, my son, come home. Come home, my son, come home. Come home, my son, come home. Come home, my son, come home.
Nobody can help but not to clap. You do not lack passion.
Wow, thank you.
Not a bit. Oh my gosh. It makes me want to cry a little.
I was handed a great lyric and it was easy to do the rest.
I mean, and it's personal, but did she lose?
Yeah. It's a personal story that she wrote about somebody she cared for who she lost. And I think it's priceless because, you know, as you go through life, you're going to lose people. If you could just hold a little piece of them in your heart and take them with you everywhere, mm-hmm. it makes life a great experience. If you don't, it makes life hell.
Mm-hmm.
And she found a way to keep this person in her heart.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot of respect for that. And I'm forever grateful to be handed something like that. It's funny. I was in Steve Oakley, my former writing partner and bandmate for 20 something years. I was in his shed and we're drinking adult beverages. And I played it for him. And I told him about how, when she showed me the lyrics, how I could see it. I could see the song. I said, so this is how it feels to be you. Because he's really good at that.
Yeah.
But for me, it was completely new. And I kind of think, yeah, it's hard because I'm not a terribly religious person, but I have a high degree of faith.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of think that maybe God just put me in that spot right there. Just allowed me to do it.
1,000%. I wasn't even there, but
I had not charted a song since college.
Uh-huh.
It took 13 hours to chart the song.
Mm.
But it was like awesome to do.
Maybe in that moment, like, you felt it because you just literally felt it. Does that make sense?
Yeah,
like, you just kind of.
Yeah. I don't want to try to figure it out.
I know.
Haven't written one like that since.
Time's a ticking. Yeah. No.
It's kind of like falling in love. You want to do it every day, right? So
that's what someone else on here said. I play this song often. It reminds me of my dad. It makes me tear up. Is what Kiki said too. So
I think that's true. I think what she said, that is mm-hmm. spot on. I share that experience. Is I picture watching my mother and father leave me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it helps to write the song that way. But I know it's not about them. I know that it's about Susie's love for this young man.
Mm-hmm.
So,
well, and just also in that beautiful thing about, again, original music and those moments, like, it's something that meant something to you. It's something that meant something to her. I'm sure with your daughter and the artwork, it meant something to them. And then now you have fans where it means something as well. And that's just something that it can't be replaced. It's there.
Yeah. Know? That's why we do this. We do this, as everyone watching, we do this for goosebumps.
We do.
We do. I don't know how to explain it any other way. People say, well, do you get paid? Well, yeah, probably enough to cover the beer and the gas. We're the band, right? So, but we do it for goosebumps. We mm-hmm. do this for those moments. I'm looking at Bronson here through the window and you right here in front of me. And that moment when you first kissed, when you felt those fireworks, that's why we do this. That's exactly what we're looking for. It's the same kind of feeling. We want to laugh. We want to cry. We want to take. I even set up my set list when I make a set list, I'll pick a song in the middle and say, this is a song where I'm going to grab their heart and hold on to it for a little while and then mm-hmm. give it back to them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what songs like this do for you. So.
Well, and I think that's so important to know that these artists need fans. They need people like you guys just listening to the show. They need the shares. They need that support to be there. And even if you just give them a moment to capture your heart, just give them a second, give them a chance, give them a feeling. And I think sometimes we forget, but art is meant to be all those feelings. Sometimes it's all those feels at once, that first kiss, that heartache, that losing somebody, that the moment, you know, you made a mistake and you can ignore it or you could fix it. Like, it's those moments that are going to just determine so much.
It's living.
Yeah.
It's living.
It's life.
I said it to my wife, my beautiful bride, Kimberly. I say all the time, we're living. If something, even sometimes when something bad happens, I'll say, but we're living. We're playing the game. We're in the game. We're doing things. we're trying to make the world a little better place than it was before we got here, and mm-hmm. you know, just keep moving on. So if you don't mind, I see we have probably 10 minutes left. I want to make sure that I plug the show.
Absolutely. Tell us where you're going to be. Let us know how to find you.
Okay. So it's getting a little confusing and I'll explain why. So I'm going to play an acoustic show, full hour and a half, and I'm going to play Angels Gathering on piano at the Opening Bell on May 18th, Saturday night, 7:00. So everyone can go. It's all ages. They have alcohol there. If you choose to have alcohol, they have great coffee because there's a coffee shop. They have food. It's just a unbelievable place. But much like that place when I was telling you before where I first saw this guitar up in the Lehigh Valley, a place called Godfrey Daniels, The opening bell has that feeling of just a 1960s, 70 something place where anyone can come and just share their feelings, their art, their music. And it's priceless. It has magic to it. It's really just a priceless place. Does it have the greatest PA in the world? Well, it comes out pretty good, but is it $1 million PA? No, but they make it sound great. It just feels good. It looks good. Everything about it really works, except when you turn the blender on when you're singing a quiet song, you know, whatever that coffee drink is. Not a fan of that. But I'll be there May 18th, Saturday. It'll be solo, and I'll do it in a format similar to this. I'll play songs that are acoustic. I'm going to play one or two new songs, which is, you know, what's queued up for the band, you know, for the band to learn. And so it's kind of cool. And then I'll play piano as well. And maybe
I haven't seen you play piano. That's new. I know you play, but it's new for it to be on stage.
I have this blessing and a curse. I love the piano. I'm not terribly gifted at it, but two of my best songs are on piano.
Okay.
So when I don't play piano, it's very difficult to integrate those into my set.
Yeah.
So you're like, oh, geez.
And now you just got to lug a piano around up on stage.
Oh, it's 88 keys, and it weighs the same as I do. This guy, Matt Murphy, who used to say, I played piano for keyboards for him for CD release. And he used to tell me, those keyboards are kicking your ass. All the time, because they're so heavy. Oh, that was before I did CrossFit and weightlifting. Bulked up.
So May 18th, 7 yeah, so, p.m., so opening here, bell.
Opening bell, May 18th, 7 p.m. That's in Dallas. It's plenty of parking. It's right around the corner from Port David's and down the street from Gilly. So there's a bazillion parking spots there, easy to get in and out of.
Yay.
Then here's the confusing part. Okay. I am doing sideman work, and I don't say I joined the band, but I'm playing with the band, Brian Shuck and Local Heroes, and he has four or five shows set up. You know Cassidy Bostick?
One hit away.
And he is just getting so good. And I'm playing on the 17th at Main Street Fest in Grapevine with him.
Okay.
So that's Thursday of May 17th. And then Friday night, I'm playing with Brian Shuck at Main Street Fest in Grapevine. Or maybe I have that backwards. It's Friday, May 17th with Cassidy. Saturday during the day with Brian Shuck.
Okay.
Saturday night, I'm playing at the opening bell.
Solo.
Sunday, I'm playing back at Main Street Fest in Grapevine with Brian.
Okay. Like,
my fingers will be falling off. But
for your originals and your songs, we're Saturday looking night. At Saturday, Saturday night. Opening bell.
Yeah. If you want to see obnoxious guitar, go to Main Street Fest too. I'll be sure to.
Well, Main Street, you can also support the other arts as well.
It's fantastic.
Kind of get a feel for everything, you know.
Yeah, and it's just been a great ride. Yeah, I'm pretty lucky. I'm watching the clock here, but I don't know who's watching this, who's listening, but I just want to say something's really important. Is I had in 2001. Mm-hmm. It was 2002 because this one was 9/11. So summer 2002, my fingers cracked. We talked about this earlier. Mm-hmm. I couldn't play guitar for 19 years. Mm. I taped them. I glued them. I got Honest John to play guitar in an old band in Mother Red Cap, or Steve made that happen, but he knew that it just, I could barely play. And even the early acoustic stuff was the same way. It was hard to play. I just glue it and grit through it. For the first two or three years, I just had a pity party about it. And I started singing a little better. Mm-hmm. I learned to play piano. I learned to play slide guitar. And I started to get the idea that maybe this was just a blessing and I didn't realize it. Mm-hmm. It led to here. I would never be here if my fingers didn't bleed. And so now when people ask me to play guitar, like when Bronson asked us to play down at the local, when he said, hey, can you sideman for local gig. Mm-hmm. Well, one, he's got $1 million voice. So I said, yes, that above all else had it. But then the other thing was that my wife and I talk about this all the time. I just say yes, mm-hmm. because I can. For a long time, I couldn't. So now I can play a little and it's kind of cool.
Well, he loves it when you play with him.
Yeah, it was a blast.
And that
pizza was incredible. In the land of terrible pizza, you had the greatest pizza. I kind of know how you figured that out.
They do have good pizza.
Yeah, it's crazy. You can't get a good pizza anywhere in the state of Texas except wherever we were.
Yeah, I think we had to give you a hard time because I don't. Did you get toppings on your pizza?
No,
he was like, I just want a really good pizza. And we were like,
I am a purist.
That's exactly what you said then, too.
And I plugged in an acoustic guitar, but I'm still purist. Yeah.
It's pretty crazy. Now, so May 18th, we're going in solo. What other shows do you have coming up past that?
Well, we have the full band show with Bronson. We're doing a fundraiser, which is the Wings of Hope.
Wings of Hope. Yep. And they're a local community business here in Burleson, Cleburne area.
That's awesome.
Yep.
And it ties in nicely with my wife's passion towards equine therapy.
I knew you guys would be the perfect fit for that.
And I have a great band. So we're going to integrate Bronson and he's going to come with us and we're going to do, I think, about 12 songs together. As a band with an extra guitar player and $1 million voice, it's ought to be good. There's no way this cannot be great.
No, it's
and
gonna be
we'll
beautiful.
Do the fundraiser and it'll be a lot of fun. We're gonna do, we're planning on doing a couple covers, so because we're not really dance bands, but we'll throw in a couple Southern rock songs so people can kind of do what they do here. Yeah, do what they do here in Texas. Kim always says, I think they taught them to dance in school because they all dance, and they like to have a good time. So that's August 2nd at. Is the Railhead?
That's at River Ranch in the Stockyards.
Yeah,
we're really stoked. And so, we're going to bring you all back on the show just to talk about that and the charity. And maybe we can get Kim up here.
That'd be cool.
She's up for it.
That's cool.
You know,
we'll perform.
No pressure, Kimberly. No pressure. We're just calling you out on the radio here, forcing you to.
She would be here now, except Kim has gotten roped into local politics. So we live in a town called Copper Canyon, which has about 1,500 people. Mm-hmm. And a lot of lands. It might have 1,500 cows and 3,000 horses. And it's just north. It's between Highland Village and Denton. Mm-hmm. And we just wanted a little piece of property in Texas, right? So we had a little kind of cool property. And now people want to build on it. Because if it's dirt in Texas, they want to turn it into homes or concrete, mm-hmm. which is breaking my heart. So
yeah, cut it out.
So Kim is... Kim's on the planning board. She doesn't have an agenda one way or the other. She knows people need a place to live, all that kind of stuff. But she's on the planning board, and the meeting is tonight.
Oh,
so she has to go.
She's ready.
Yeah, she has to go to PTZ planning zone. I forgot what it's called. Mm-hmm. So it's a zoning board meeting. So she got roped into that. And it's kind of good because she's not a developer. Mm-hmm. So she can't be bought. She can't be influenced. There's no quid pro quo. There's no, you couldn't even have the illusion of, mm-hmm. of anything other than. You know, authenticity.
She's non-biased, authentic.
With a little bit of an East Coast attitude. So if they come in under the requirement, they're going to know that they didn't meet the requirement. Mm-hmm. And so she'll execute the zoning as per master plan to keep our town from turning into Plano.
I like it.
Not that I don't love Plano.
Just let them go to Plano and build a house.
But they have perfected how to make a city, only a couple stories tall. Mm-hmm. Which is pretty cool. I don't think we could pull that off where we are. I'd like to just keep the cows.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
So I may say this, but I can hear cows from my front porch.
No, oh, I love that.
And there are horses across the street. There's horses in.
It probably helps songwriting sitting out there on the patio, just kind of
you would think,
feeling.
I have no rhyme or reason how this works. So what'll happen? Somebody will tell me something and I'll try to personalize it. And that's pretty much it. That's the game. But some things happen. I mean, I have a song that I'm going to do at Opening Bell on May 18th. That is a song I wrote about Kim. And I played it the last time I played there. I played there in January. Mm-hmm. And I didn't let anyone in my house hear it. Kim had never heard it. Megan had never. I was hiding the writing process. I had been writing it since the moment we had moved to Texas. Aww. And it's called Country Girl. And the hook is, look at me, I'm falling for a country girl. And every time she went deeper into country. Every time, first she got a little language. And then she learned to shoot. She learned to dance. She we took dance lessons. She has a horse.
Yeah.
So she's just gone country. She loves it. And so every time she went a little deeper, I would write another verse. My notebook's just full of just every now and then there's another verse of Country Girl.
So is the song over or you finished writing it because she's as country as she can get?
We checked all the boxes. I think we checked all the boxes before we met because when I play with Bronson, I had a Telecaster and I said, that's it. We did it all. I got a gun. I got a horse. I got dogs. We took dance lessons and we have a horse.
Love it. Well, I'm about to lose you, but I wanted to just thank you for being on the show. You guys, please go find Roger, all streaming platforms, YouTube, follow him, go check his shows out. And we appreciate you guys listening in. Please keep sharing the show. And we will see you guys next Monday on Banded.
From Burleson to Venus and Grand View to Godley, this is the voice of Johnson County, JoCo Community Radio.